Hello everyone. Today we will talk about one of the very important molecular interaction which stabilize the structure of biomolecules, DNA, proteins, etc. This is called ionic interaction or salt bridge interaction. We have already talked about hydrogen bond in one of the earlier lectures. So these molecular interactions are attractive or repulsive in nature depending on the charge. And this interaction is basically between non-bonded atoms. For example, if you boil water from liquid state, water turn into vapors. Vapor is a gas state of water. So in that you do not break any oxygen-hydrogen bond. Rather, you end up breaking intermolecular interaction which holds water molecules together in form of liquid, that is hydrogen bond. So that's how these intermolecular interactions work. You, by increasing temperature, you only break those intermolecular interactions which are weak in nature. Similarly, ionic interaction is also belong to the same category. And even when you do denaturation of double-stranded DNA, both the strand of DNA molecule, they are separated. So in that case also, you only break hydrogen bond, which is non-covalent interaction between two strands of DNA. So they are also, these molecular interactions are very important in diverse areas of say in protein folding. A protein fold in solution acquire a globular shape because of these non-covalent interactions only. Even in drug design, a drug compound which binds to its receptor throw only these non-covalent interactions, and different cellular functions, DNA binding protein, protein-protein interaction, those most of them, they fall into this category of molecular interactions which are non-covalent and weak in nature. So they are also known as non-covalent interactions or intermolecular interactions. And molecular interactions are, they are not basically bonds. We call them like hydrogen bond or ionic bond. They are not bonds, because bonds are something which can hold atoms together within a molecule. But these interactions, they don't hold permanently molecules together, but they keep changing. They are very fluidy, they keep changing, and they are very weak in strength when you compare with a covalent bond between two atoms. All molecular interactions are fundamentally electrostatic in nature, and they all obey Coulomb's law. Even in case of hydrogen bond, we have seen that hydrogen bond is a result of ionic interaction only. Ionic interaction means which can exist between positive and negative charge. In case of hydrogen bond, we could see that in earlier lecture, that when hydrogen is attached to a more electronegative atom like nitrogen, oxygen or fluorine, that leads to delocalization of the shared pair of electronic cloud, and that's why there is a generation of dipole. And that when this dipole come in contact with some another charge atom, that could attract, that was hydrogen bond. So all the interaction, in fact, all the interactions in biological system, they follow Coulomb's law, because those are between positive and negative charge only. The difference between them, all of them, is the magnitude of charge which is attracting to each other. That is, for example, in case of hydrogen bond, that charge separation, the charge produced is less in comparison to ionic interaction. So ionic interaction or electrostatic interaction, they are same thing. They are attractive or repulsive. If two ions, they come together in close proximity and they have same charge, they repel each other, and when they have opposite charge, they attract each other. And this ion formation is basically result of polarization of a bond which is pushed to extreme, results in total charge separation and formation of ions, and that is that also due to loss of molecular orbital. For example, if there is a COH bond or OH bond, oxygen and hydrogen single bond, when you break this OH bond, the oxygen atom get negatively charged, and ion formation occurs. So when the negative charge ion is in close proximity of any positive charge ion, that attract each other, and this interaction is called ionic or electrostatic interaction. And the formation of these ion pair, two oppositely charged ion come together in a close distance, and this is called ion pair formation. This ion pair formation is thermodynamically driven by entropy. For example, when you have a free ion in solution, it has not yet made pair. For example, this is positive charge ion, and you have a negative charge ion in solution, and solvent is water here. So these ions, both the ions are heavily solvated. It means that they are water molecules. They are water molecules which interact on the surface of both the ions before they form ion pair. Similarly, negative charge ion also. So when they come together and form ion pair, so they come in close proximity, so they can interact with each other. So in this situation, what happens? These water molecules, the water molecules which are at the interface, these water molecules are liberated, they become free. These are, you can imagine them, water molecules. H2O. And before ion pair formation, these water molecules, because they were bonded with the ions, means their entropy was lowered, their freedom, degree of freedom was less, which is a thermodynamically unstable state. But when the ion pair formation occur, when this interaction exists between two ions, these waters become free. Free means their entropy change, delta S, if you see delta S of the system will be high because of liberation of these water molecules. And that's what we say, the entropy drives formation of this ion pair, and this is entropy of water molecules. In fact, when you break these hydrogen bond between water and ion, enthalpy wise that give positive change. But because of high change in delta S of water molecule, this becomes a spontaneous process, because we know that delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S, where T is temperature. So when you have high change in delta S, because delta S is increased for this system, because water molecules are being more free, so the T delta S goes too high, and as a result delta G for this interaction become negative, which is favorable. So that's why we say that this ion pair, the ionic interaction formation, is basically driven by entropy of water molecules. Then they are strengthened. Breaking of ion water bond give rise to positive enthalpy change, but the entropy, overall entropy change, is very high to overcome the positive change in delta H, so that delta G overall become negative and the reaction become favorable. And this strength of this interaction is increased when dielectric constant of the medium is lowered. That is because this is ionic interaction and it follows Coulomb's law. As per the Coulomb's law, the force between two ions that would depend is directly proportional to the charge Q1 and Q2, is charge on both the ions, magnitude of the charge, and that is inversely proportional to distance. If these two atoms are, what distance they are, so distance is square, that is inversely proportional to the distance is square, R square here. And also this force between both the ions would be inversely proportional to epsilon here. Epsilon is basically a dielectric constant of the medium. So when dielectric constant of the medium is low, the force between both the ions, that is strong, that is more. So for example, if you talk about one ionic interaction is kept in water, and same interaction is measured in some non-polar solvent like carbon tetrachloride or alcohol. So in both the cases, the strength of the attractive force of that ionic interaction or electrostatic interaction will be different, because dielectric constant of non-polar solvent is less. That's why it will exert more force. Both the ions will have a stronger interaction in non-polar solvent in comparison to water or less polar solvent. And two ions can come close to a distance, to some distance which is sum of their van der Waal radii. They cannot come too close, lesser than sum of their both the ions van der Waal radii, otherwise they will repel each other. Then there are many examples of ionic interactions in biomolecules. For example, in case of interaction between DNA and magnesium ion. Magnesium ion is having positive charge, and phosphate group on DNA, RNA, it has negative charge. So magnesium ion is stabilized by making ionic interactions with the phosphate group of nucleic acids. Then there are many factors which can affect the strength of ionic interactions. That's a distance. First thing is distance, because the Coulombic force. So if it is kept to a optimal distance, only then it will have attractive force, otherwise it will disappear. Geometry. Geometry means the angle. Two ions at what angle they are coming together. Generally in proteins, 150 to 180 degree angle forming ionic interaction, they are more stabilizing in comparison to lesser bond angle. Nature of medium. Nature of medium means whether it's been kept in non-polar medium or polar medium. For example, if you think about ionic interaction in protein which is present on the surface of the protein, and one in ionic interaction being present in hydrophobic core of the protein. So interaction which is present in core of the protein, that will have more strength because of environment, because in non-polar, the protein core is non-polar, so their dielectric constant will be less in comparison to the outside environment, the surface the interaction is existing. Then it's also influenced by pH of the medium. pH of the medium means if you change pH, the charge also changes. For example, let's take an example of carboxylic acid, COOH. This group can be ionized, it ionizes into COO minus and H plus. And where does it do that? There is a rule, if this called pK value, where you have 50% ionization is a pK. For example, this compound has pK value of say 3.0. It means if you keep this compound at pH below its pK value, it will exist in protonated state. It will have COH group, and COH has no charge, so it cannot form any ionic interaction with positive charge ion. Only if you raise pH above 3.0, only then you will have this CO minus species, because this is a requirement for ionic interaction. It should exist, both the molecules coming together, they should exist in ionic state. So when you keep this compound below above 3 pH, only then you will have CO minus species. So it means if this compound is being involved in any ionic interaction, it should be kept at pH above 3.0. Otherwise, if it is less than 3.0, it won't be ionic, it won't be having negative charge, it cannot form ionic interaction. Similarly, for a positive charge also, the same rule is applicable. Then it's also temperature also affect, because when you raise temperature, thermal vibration of atoms and molecules changes. As a result, distance between two ions will change, and if it go beyond a limited distance, both the ions, the force existing between them will be disrupted. And salt, because salt is also charged, high salt concentration also disturb, also interrupt ionic interactions. Salt bridges. ionic interactions existing in macromolecules. For example, in case of proteins, they are called salt bridges, because salt bridges are basically combination of two non-covalent interactions which exist simultaneously: hydrogen bond and ionic or electrostatic interaction. And this interaction is found between negatively charged side chain of negative charge amino acid like aspartic acid, glutamic acid, or C terminal of protein and amino acid, where COH group is there, negative charge is there. When these groups interact with side chain of basic amino acid like histidine, lysine, arginine, or N-terminal of proteins and amino acid which is positively charged. So this interaction between basic amino acid and acid amino acid that give rise to salt bridge interaction, where you have hydrogen bond and ionic interaction existing together. So this is an example of salt bridge between side chain of lysine amino acid and glutamic acid amino acid. So we know that in lysine, the terminal, the side chain is NH3 plus, positively charged. You have amino group, protonated amino group. And when this is in contact with a COO minus, negative charge, glutamic acid side chain, the negative charge on glutamic acid attract positive charge on side chain of lysine. So this is electrostatic interaction or ionic interaction. But same time, if you see here in the same interaction, this NH3, in NH3 you have amino nitrogen atom covalently linked to 3 proton. It means there is a difference, of electronegativity between hydrogen and nitrogen atom that give rise to polarization of this bond. And that's what is the definition of hydrogen bond, which we have discussed in earlier video. So, and this hydrogen, when it come in contact with this oxygen, there is an attractive force exists between them, that's called hydrogen bond. So in this case, you have ionic interaction between positive and negative charge, and same time oxygen atom, the lone pair, get attracted towards proton, hydrogen of this amino group. So both these two interaction exist together, and that's what you call salt bridge. Salt bridges, they are also pH dependent, like ionic interaction. When you change pH, strength of salt bridge can be increased or decreased, and they make group more stable, hence alter pK value, pK value of the group. So how does it alter pK value? Again, we'll take the same example where you have interaction between say some acidic group in protein, CO minus for example, and this is in proximity with side chain of some lysine or some basic amino acid, NH3 plus. So when this interaction exists, it means they stabilize each is attractive force between this negative ion and positive ion. So CO minus stabilizes protonated state of amino group, which is NH3 here, so that NH3 plus become more stable. Similarly, NH3 plus, the charge on NH3 plus stabilizes the charge on NH3 plus stabilizes negative charge on CO minus. It simply means when these two groups are attracting each other, in that case CO minus cannot accept proton easily, because deprotonated state of CO minus is being stabilized by NH3 plus. It simply means CO minus cannot accept proton, means it can, the proton donating tendency is increased, and proton donor tendency, hydrogen donating tendency is called acidity. Acidity means the pK value for this group would go down, it will become more acidic. Similarly, because CO minus is stabilizing protonated state of amino group, So in this way, this proton, extra proton with amino group is not released easily. And releasing proton, we know that giving proton is called acidic behavior. Accepting proton is a basic behavior. So here, it means for the pK value, it become more basic. The amino group will become more basic, means proton accepting tendency of amino group is increased when it is interacting with CO minus group. In that way, the pK value of this group will go up. So that's what we say when these ionic or salt bridge interaction, they exist together, the group stabilizes each other. As a result, their acidic and basic behavior of the group changes, and hence their pI value of protein also changes. This topic we have discussed in great detail in other video earlier, where we have talked about theoretical, how to calculate theoretical and actual experimental pI of proteins.